And Anderson is a very great research scholar in cognitive biology. He has made a model of declarative memory and procedural memory. He has encompassed everything, whatever that is connected with the context, whatever that is connected with a context, that is known as episodic, and whatever that is independent of your context, that is known as semantic. That has two more divisions. Semantic division, that has two more divisions. If you want to know about you, that is known as autobiography. If you want about others, that is known as exobiography. Endobiographic, exobiographic, xenographic, cosmographic, topographic is understand about the way, pathway, etc. For example, understanding the pathway in knives, just as bullets, even they return safely from their own villages whenever they go to the towns, they just repatriate very safely, as if they have been programmed by a computer chip. So, understanding about the way, understanding the distance, recognizing the place even in darkness, mist, and various other combinations of other obstacles and demarcifiers, that is known as topographic memory. So, biographic, cartographic, demographic, technographic, photographic, phonographic, neurographic, orographic, innumerable types of memories have been made by our Shastra, they have been enlisted by our people. So, we have to get all of those things principle. We know about all of these memories. The problem is the damage. That's what I have been discussing in the slide also. If somebody is conducting a seminar for poverty and hunger and saying that money and food is the remedy, the person will be pelted by stones. Because that is known for everybody. Everybody knows that food is the solution for hunger and money is the solution for poverty. But how to get that in hand is the practical thing which we have to discuss. It is by damages. Nobody is bothering about the damages. We want to make a school where a person's physiological as well as maternal history should be recorded. What are the various sedatives, suppressors, somnolizers and surgical operations that have been done? What are the injections that have been put? What are the enzymic and hormonic and epidural treatments that have been administered for the mother before pregnancy, at the time of pregnancy? We must have a detailed record about the prenatal, postnatal, seminatal, postnatal diseases of the person, whether he is affected by any cerebral malaria or any other disease at the time of the womb in the intrauterine status or at the time of 1 or 2 years, that should be recorded. Because that will create four major problems. One, lack of interest or multi-diversification about knowledge. The person will be an irritant, so that continuously he cannot see the teacher for 20 minutes, he cannot hear any teacher for more than 20 minutes, he cannot sit at the place for more than 30 minutes. He will be allured only by the natural fascinators, known as TV, media, play, and any other thing, where the intellect has no work at all. So this is a natural record, prenatal record and postnatal record, and the infancy medical record which is to be preserved for all of the people. Yeah, recent Stockholm Convention, they made a result. Due to the various analyses that have been made with millions of students in the world, iron and magnesium, along with that of iodine, they are two suppressors of anti-memory status and producers of memory. They are known as lubricants. And calcium and various other things which we are used in the form of fertilizer, they are known as heaters. Most of the people, about 63% of the student community is having the iodine deficiency. Is having a magnesium deficiency. So immediately the person is not studying, compelling him to carry a rice bag of 100 kilos, it is idiotic. If it is not taken care, that is lunatic. If it is considered to be taken care and without proper tools, if it is extra managed, it is idiotic. Neither be idiotic nor be lunatic. It should be understood by the person's physiobiological ability. Is anybody in your school or in a family concerned about the iodine magnesium? If the physical non-cooperation is there, how the child can read? Attention of a child. Withstanding attention of the child is manipulated only by physical points, physical elements. To see, to observe, to hear, to be positioned in the place, and to be a salubrious receiver of all of the essential messages. He should have a physical capable fit, benefit, but he is having ill fit and malfit. That should be also taken into account. These are the various things. Now we are having innumerable type of damages now. Two things I want to say now. There is something known as amygdala. Amygdala is controlling all the emotions. I told you in one seminar, you scold somebody for 10 minutes with over emotional eruption, volcanic eruption of your emotional anger in the form of hatredness or hostility or anything else. 10 minutes you be angry with somebody who is present before you or outside. 10 minutes. The energy that is exhausted is more than enough to manipulate or memorize the 700 and odd shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. The energy required for memorizing Bhagavad Gita is the same energy that is mismanaged, mis-executed, or more mercifully that is exploded in the pretext of hatredness, in the pretext of jealousy, in the pretext of various other psychological errors and imbalances. Whatever we are doing, they are over consuming, they are over erupting the status of a person's reasonable thirst for knowledge. It has been scientifically observed too. It is known as known as cortisol. Cortisol injection is there, and there is epinephrine injection is there. It is injected for boosting these amygdala. Now, how it is possible? These type of things will create hormonic imbalance and they will destroy our humanistic qualities like love, affection, mutual forgiving, management, relation making, fraternity, and various other qualities will totally dismantle and reduce in that. So, to create intellect, medicine is not the proper way, machine is not the proper way. There are four things. One is master, second is the mind, third thing is the medicine, fourth thing is the machine. Medicine and machine is Western intervention. If you don't want to create, if you are not capable, replace a chip and replace a computer that will do everything for you. Even eating and drinking it can do after 20 years. So machine replacement and medicine replacement is the Western error. Mind replacement and master intervention is the greatness of Oracle. If you are following the same thing, why you have to be Indian and what is the necessity of the taking and talking about scriptures? Scriptures that do with the involvement of great masters. That is a lively intervention. Second thing is a lovely intervention. If you are concerned, that is a lively intervention. If somebody is concerned for you, that is a lovely intervention. Why do you deal with medicines and these machines which they are doing now? That is a lively intervention. So these things, this hypothalamus and this amygdala, these things are now managed by some sort of hormonic intensifiers or stimulators, which is very dangerous for the whole system at all. Now as a result, we are getting more diseases. More you are inventing things, Alzheimer's disease, amnesia, hyperthalamia, then Kirosophy syndrome or the amnesic confabulatory syndrome that we are having now, then anomia we are having now, then nomemia we are having now, anomial asesthesia we are having now, bipolarism we are having now, selective amnesia, partial amnesia, contextual amnesia, coupled amnesia, coma, all of these various problems are there, frequently attack these human beings because of their mismanagement of intellect and disrespect towards the gods of wisdom. These things have created this problem. Once again, we have to repatriate to the golden footprints of our ancestors to realize everything as a consciousness form. And a very great universality and eternity in the form of purity is to be understood in that. There is a retrograde learning process in the Western science. And second thing is, what is the process of shaping and scanning? There are numerous cases. What do you mean by shaping? What do you mean by shaping and spacing? If you learn things by gradually, for example, I am telling you a shloka. If I am repeating the same shloka for 100 times, making you to get a long-term memory, that is known as shaping or spacing. Cramming is a method by which, if I say immediately, you can attempt it. So there are two possibilities. You have to select the people with the cramming facility. You have to boost the spacing facility into promotable cramming facility. There are two possibilities. One is to select the people as per their cramming nature and their shaping or spacing nature. All the people, those who are spaceable, they should be promoted to the crammable. This is also a system. Now the Germans, they are researched in producing some orders, O-O-D-O-R order. In producing some orders which are bio-responsible, which are bio-compatible and palatable, by inducing which they are going to boost the, promote the memory about the recent incidents. And Ohio University, they have made a very wonderful research, I want to say. Ohio State University, Department of Cognitive Technology, they have created a very wonderful this thing. They have found out in grown adults, if they think that they know more than others, that obstructs a person's proceeding of memory, which is equal to our saying that Vidya Vinaya is Dhogavati. By means of Vinaya, by means of humility, by means of self-humility, by means of a person's observance and submission to God, thinking himself humble will promote a person to have a more spatial and compassionate of knowledge. Now, what you said, university's record says that if a person is having the possessiveness of the grade of the knowledge, that obstructs a person to boost his memory or to expand the viability of his memory or cognitive operations. That is recently been done by the people. So, innumerable researches like that have been done about genetic memory, involuntary memory, cultural memory, tissue memory, cellular memory, then muscle memory, incorporated memory, about synaptic pruning and synaptic plasticity, about false memory syndrome, 200 researches are going on in the Western world without any purpose and end. Like that, innumerable things are going there. Coming to our own Eastern school of thought as a concluding remark of the session, number one, we have a lot of helpers. If we have a helper, then the innate possibility is lost, it is eroded. We have calculator, we have computer, we have each and every helper. For example, the first helper is, I know that whenever the printing industry started, the knowledge was put into the grave. Whenever the printing industry simultaneously commenced the technology showroom, as well as it connected the funeral for the traditional system of the effective local. Whenever you can print, whenever you can restore, now you are million words are irreplaceable, irretrievable, irrevocable loss of your inherent memory is incorporated there in the pretext of technological development. There are a lot of helpers, but you must know that helpers are just beginners, they are not runners. Immediately you cannot go through an ashram chati or the padati or the system of way of great stalwarts and great people who are spiritually perspicacious and clairvoyant authorities. You cannot go tomorrow. You can start it as a starter, but the runner should be your inner intelligence, not artificial intelligence. That is about helpers. And second thing is, there are a lot of innumerable elements like screen callers. Now we are having a lot of reminders and recallers. Whenever we are taking a notebook, we are taking a hint, we are making a summary, we are processing everything externally. They are known as recallers. That which helps you to learn, that which helps in recaller, you are having innumerable things. I have already told about oblivion, that it is a very great thing. If you don't forget things, three things cannot be done. First thing, your emotional balance will not be made. If you are thinking about the person who has quoted you the previous year, till now, what you can do effectively? So this type of oblivion, it makes you to rectify yourself. It gives you an opportunity to learn about new things. And eroding things, that is de-learning and relearning, is possible only by this loss of memory. So this oblivion gives you rectification possibility. Oblivion gives you emotional rest and tranquility. Oblivion gives you more further learning and elaboration of your knowledge, not evaporation of your knowledge. That is possible only by oblivion. So oblivion, forgetting things, it is also a benefit. There are innumerable ways in our shastras. Havana, by doing the Medha Sutta Homa, we can get knowledge. That is Havana, Pujana, Bhajana, Sthavana, Satsanga Sevana, Vikshana, Sparsha, Divya Sparsha, Divyanagraha, Bodha, Upadesha, Diksha, Achara, Samskara. These are the innumerable Eastern methodologies for getting knowledge.
Like that is known as appropriate.